Hello friends, welcome to TechDose, and in this lecture I will show you how to write your first program in Prolog. Okay, so for writing first program in Prolog, you need to start your sweep Prolog. I had already shown you how to install it. So tap on the Windows button and then write sweep. You will see that Prolog is a desktop app written here. Now Prolog will start. Okay, so this is how it starts. Now you need to create a new file in order to write your code. So click on the file menu and then click on new. Now you can see that you will be presented with the location and wherever you want to save it, okay. I just want to save it here. And while writing the file name, you see that save as type prolog source is written over here, and if not, then select it, prolog source, and then write any random file name. So let us just write facts, because we will be writing the code taking the facts, so it will be meaningful. Facts.pl, you will include this extension .pl, okay, and then click on save. When you click on save, then you can see that the editor will open. This is a Prolog editor. Okay, now I'll just maintain its size. Now we can start writing our code. So I had shown you in the previous lecture what are facts and how to write a fact. So let us include a fact, like we include valuable gold. Okay, and then what, after writing a fact, after writing any number of facts, okay, when you are done, you need to compile it. So click on the compile and then compile buffer. There is also a shortcut, Control C and then Control B. Okay, click on OK and it will be compiled. Now in our query section, you can post a question like valuable gold, that means, and then full stop, that means is gold valuable. Press enter, then it is returning true, because gold is valuable according to our database. This valuable gold is our knowledge base. Okay, so whatever is written over here in this code section is our knowledge base, and this is the query section where we ask the question from the Prolog machine. Okay, now suppose we ask a different question like valuable salt. So since salt is not in our database, so since valuable is in our database, so while comparison, it will find that valuable relationship exists, but while comparing its parameter like gold, when gold is compared against salt, then it will not match. Okay, so it should return false. So you can see that it is returning false. Okay, so let us quickly add some more facts. Now suppose we have included all these facts. Okay, so we need to compile it. You can compile it from here or use the shortcut buttons, Control C and then Control B. So it has been compiled. Okay, so you can see here that it has been compiled. This is written, and four clauses have been compiled, because one was compiled earlier. You can see that here there are five clauses. So after that, suppose we post a question like father Mary, Jane, then full stop, then what should the Prolog machine do? It will search for this relationship father. So you can see that we have only one relationship with the name father, and in here it is written John dot Mary. Oh, actually it will be John comma Mary. So let us see, this is a returning error, because the relationship father, we have defined only one parameter, because this our separator was comma, but by mistake I have included in here dot. So it is telling us that whatever question we have posted is of parameter of length 2, so for father/2. But however, there are definitions for father/1, that means the relationship which we have defined in our knowledge base is having only one parameter, and we are asking that relationship with two parameters, so it will return an error. Okay, so let us quickly modify it and see. So in here there will be comma, Control C then Control B, then okay. Let us now ask the same question. Okay, father Mary comma Jane. Now you can see that father, here there is father. Okay, we have two parameters, John comma Mary. Here we have two parameters, Mary comma John. Now the corresponding parameters should match in order to return true. So you can see that Mary is matched with John and it is not matching, so no further matching will be done and it will return false. So let us see. See, you can see that it is returning false. Now if we ask in the reverse manner, like Jane comma Mary, then the corresponding elements will match and so it will return true. Oops, why is it returning false? Okay, I have written there John and here I am writing Jane, that's why. Father Mary comma Jane, if we write, then it will return false. And then father Jane, oops, again I am writing Jane, what the heck. John comma Mary, now it will return true. Okay, it in the first case, if we would have written John instead of Jane, then also false would have come. So let us see, Mary comma John, and you can see that false is coming. Okay, so this is how we can build facts in the knowledge base and then we can keep asking questions regarding those facts. Okay, so this is not the main use of Prolog. The main use would have been that if we would have asked who is the father of John, okay, or who is the father of Mary, then it would have been meaningful if we would have got the right answer. So for understanding all these things, you need to understand what is a variable, because we will be making use of variable to see these type of answers, like who is the father of Mary and all these stuffs. Okay, so stick to our channel for more Prolog videos and hopefully we will see variables and constants in our next lecture. Okay, and if you like this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe for more such videos. Till then, thank you.